Today is the 79th anniversary of the Quit India Day, and on the slogan of Quit Modi, Save India, the working class, the peasantry and the agricultural worker are on a nationwide protest action demanding the repeal of the agri laws, the MSP legal right, and opposing this large-scale privatization and repeal of the labor laws. Against all these anti-people policies of this government and on these demands, there is big protests that are going on all across the country. The CPIM expresses its complete solidarity and support with these, and we are demanding of the Modi government that immediately withdraw these agri laws and enact a legislation to the right to the farmers to sell at an MSP that is cost C2 cost plus 50%. This must be done immediately. That is the demand. Well, the communique of the Central Committee is there before all of you. We discussed essentially three issues: the review of the assembly elections, the current political developments and the tasks that flow from there, and the campaign call, and the convening of the 23rd Party Congress of the CPIM. As far as the election reviews are concerned, our conclusion is that these round of results has been a setback for the BJP, except for in Assam, where with a wafer-thin vote share margin of 0.78% difference between the Mahajot and the BJP front, they retain their government. But in all the other three major states, that is Bengal, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, there was a very, very big setback for the BJP. This unity of forces, political forces and secular opposition, to launch more stronger protest movements in the country against this misrule. None of these issues will be discussed in the parliament. Now they say you discuss the farmers issue but not repeal of laws. That is the demand. That is what we have demanded even before this farmers agitation started. We opposed these ordinances when they came. And Pegasus, of course, they say there is nothing to discuss. Now France has ordered an inquiry. Mexico has ordered an inquiry. Israel itself is investigating on the role of the NSO, whether this spyware is being misused or not. But the Indian government refuses. There is only one question we are asking Modi to answer. Has the government or any of its agencies had the contract with the Israeli NSO, the leader, world leader in cyber surveillance, for the use of Pegasus military spyware for surveillance of individuals? Answer this question. The refusal to answer is the confirmation that the government is doing it. Many of your profession, their names have come, politicians' names have come, an ex-judge of the Supreme Court's name has come, from the registry of the Supreme Court, the officers' names have come, an ex-election commissioner's name has come, an ex-CBI director's name has come. So this is ominous in the sense it's not only a violation of the fundamental right to privacy of an individual, but it is attacking every institution of constitutional democracy in India.